सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ओम। भगवद्गीता 17th चैप्टर 20th वर्स। दातव्यम् इति यद् दानं दीयते अनुपकारिणे देशे काले च पात्रे च तद्दानं सात्विकं स्मृतम्। नाउ आफ्टर हैविंग एक्सप्लेन्ड डिफरेंट ऑस्टेरिटीज अकॉर्डिंग टू द गुणास सत्व रजस एंड तमस, नाउ श्री कृष्णा इज एक्सप्लेनिंग डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ चैरिटी और दाना। देशे इन अ फिट प्लेस, काले इन अ अप्रोप्रिएट टाइम, इन एन अप्रोप्रिएट टाइम, च एंड पात्रे टू अ वर्दी पर्सन, च एंड दातव्यम टू गिव इज राइट इति विद दिस आइडिया। अनुपकारिणे टू वन हु डज नॉट डू एनी सर्विस इन रिटर्न, यत विच दानम गिफ्ट दीयते इज गिवन, तत दैट दानम गिफ्ट सात्विकम सात्विका स्मृतम इज हेल्ड टू बी। सो अ पर्सन हु थिंक्स टू गिव इज राइट, इट इज गुड टू गिव थिंग्स एज डोनेशन। अ पर्सन हु थिंक्स दैट एंड टू गिव होम, टू गिव टू अ पर्सन हु डज नो सर्विस इन रिटर्न, हु डज नॉट गिव एनीथिंग इन रिटर्न, एंड टू गिव टू अ पर्सन एंड इन अ फिट प्लेस, इन अ प्लेस विच इज अप्रोप्रिएट, एट अ टाइम विच इज अप्रोप्रिएट, एंड टू अ वर्दी पर्सन, दैट गिफ्ट और दैट दाना इज सात्विका। ओनली सम डेज एगो आई वॉज बींग टोल्ड बाई अ पर्सन दैट इट इज अ बिग रैकेट काइंड ऑफ वेन यू हियर इन सम प्लेसेस वेन यू कंडक्ट अ स्मॉल पार्टी for your housewarming, griha pravesha. And when that party is conducted, people come and they give you gifts. So depending on the menu, they give you gifts, different kinds of gifts. So I'm talking about Kerala. In some parts in Kerala, this happens. It's very, very rampant. So these gifts, when somebody does this housewarming party, these gifts which are basically, gifts means money. They give money, they put it in an envelope and give it. And these amounts, they can go up to 15-20 lakhs. I'm talking about this happening in middle class or lower middle class families, not upper class families. And yet, in one party, they call it party, this collection can go up to 20 lakhs or more even, depending upon the menu. So if you have all kinds of food, then the collection will be more. But, and here is the catch, these people have to return this money. So when they will be invited for that kind of party by the people who have given money, they will have to also return money. So it's like loan but not loan, without interest. And many people do only this. They change houses frequently because they can generate money like that. So there are so many kinds of things going on. So here people are giving gift expecting a return. In fact, they are investing, they are not giving gift, they are expecting a return. But sattvika gift is what? Anupakarine, knowing well that the person will not give, or not expecting any return. Anupakarine. Upakara means there will be no upakara, no use of that gift or that dana. Even then the sattvika person will give to an appropriate person, worthy person, at a particular time, means the time when it is fit to be given. And one who cannot return means one who cannot return, either that person doesn't have the ability to return, or even if that person has the ability, is not expected to return. That kind of gift. So this gift given and forgotten, that is sattvika person's gift. Whereas rajasika person, yattu pratyupakarartham phalam uddishya vapunaha diyate cha pariklishtam taddanam rajasam smritam. Yat, what, tu, but, and pratyupakarartham, with a view to receiving in return, phalam cha uddishya, and the fruit uddishya, looking for, va punaha again, pariklishtam, reluctantly diyate, is given, tat, that danam, gift, rajasam smritam. Rajasika smritam is held to be. So what gift is given with a view that I will get something in return? Just like the gifts given or money is given in parties here. So gift which is given with a view to receiving something in return or looking for the fruit. So either you receive it in return or you give like a bribe. So I have given you the gift, so get me this work done or let my work be done. And also reluctantly, pariklishtam, reluctantly, oh, I have to give this gift, like that. That gift is rajasika. So people, they go to marriage ceremonies, they attend wedding ceremonies, and then they calculate how much of food is being served. Then they calculate how much cost it would be. And accordingly, they give money there. A gift also they will calculate. In advance itself they will calculate. Mostly they will have this as menu. So that will cost only this much. So we should give only this much gift. So that kind of gift given. And most people give gift. And sometimes it is worse. They get gift from some wedding ceremony. They might have got the gift and they will give it back to some other person. So sometimes one's gift can go around and return to oneself. So like that, things happen. Why? Because pariklishtam, with lot of difficulty they give gift. Oh, I have to go to a birthday party. Oh, I have to get a gift. Not that I give gift where it is necessary and where I am giving and also without expecting anything. No. For a rajasika person, if that person spends even 1 rupee, there should be some gain out of that. Some gain out of that. And so, if they give some gift, there will be some gain. Without gain, they will not give any gift. Without gain, they will not do anything. So, it's a rajasika quality. Then, adesha kale yaddanam apatre bhyascha diyate asatkritam avagnyatam tattamasam udakritam. Adesha kale, at the wrong place or time, apatre bhyascha, and to an unworthy person or unworthy people, asatkritam, without any regard, avagnyatam, with disdain or without any respect, yat, that danam, gift, diyate, is given, tat, that tamasika, that is tamasika udahritam, is declared to be. So the gift that is given at the wrong place or time, exactly opposite of sattvika gift, to unworthy people and without regard or with disdain, that is declared to be tamasika. Sometimes people, when they serve food, they don't serve food, they simply throw food. They just throw it on the plates. It's so insulting to the person who is eating. Similarly, some people, they distribute clothes, they just throw it on the people who are receiving. So the idea is, I've just given you, get lost. So disdain, without regard, without respect, you give a gift. And to unworthy people who don't deserve that gift, actually. They might be having such clothes so much, they may be starting a clothes store based on what they have got, to give like that. That is called tamasika. And gift that is given at a wrong place and a wrong time, that is to people who don't deserve it, that is tamasika gift. So Gifts also have been classified into Sattvika, Rajasika and Tamasika. Then Shri Krishna says, Om Tat Saditi Nirdesho Brahmanas Trividha Smritaha Brahmanas Tena Vedascha Yajnascha Vihita Pura Om Tat Sat Iti. Om, the mantra Om, Tat, that Sat, the eternal principle, Sat, iti, thus, Brahmanah of Brahman, Trividah Nirdeshah, triple Nirdeshah, designation, a triple name of Brahman, Smritah has been declared. Tena, by that, Brahmanah, the Brahmanas, Cha, and Vedah, the Vedas, Cha, and Yajnah, the Yajnas, Pura of old, Vihitaha, were made. So, Om Tat Sat, this has been declared to be the triple designation or triple nomenclature of Brahman. By that were made of old the Brahmanas, the Vedas and the Yajnas. So, by this the Brahmanas of the Vedas were made and the Vedas were made and the Yajnas or sacrifices were made. So, Om is the main name of God because it includes everything that is seen in this universe and beyond this universe also. Also, it means Om can also mean yes, and Tat means that which is indefinable, which can be only pointed to, which can be only hinted at, it can be only described indirectly. And Sat is reality, the eternal reality, which is always permanent. So, all these are the characteristics of Brahman, and Brahman has been told like that. And it is based on Brahman that all the Vedas, all the yajnas or sacrifices and the way of doing the sacrifices, everything has been made, has been based. Tasmad, Om ityudahritya Yajna dana tapakriyaha pravartante vidhanoktaha satatam brahmavadinam. Tasma, therefore, Om, Om, iti udahritya, uttering thus, brahmavadinam of the followers of the Vedas, vidhanoktaha, as instructed in the vidhana scriptures, yajna dana tapakriyaha, the acts of yajna, sacrifice, dana, gift, tapa, austerity, satatam always pravartante. One has to begin or do. So here, Shri Krishna is summing up. He had described in detail the different kinds of austerity and different kinds of dana, charity, different kinds of yajna, sacrifices done by Rajasika, Tamasika, Sattvika people. And so here he says, one has to utter the syllable Om and do all these practices as given in the ordinance, as given in the scriptures, and always begin by the followers of the Vedas. Means always these practices are begun by chanting Om and they are done by following in the letter and spirit the instructions given by the Vedas, and this is done by people who Brahmavadinam, who are the followers of the Vedas. So essentially one has to follow the Vedas in all these acts, that is the idea. Then Shri Krishna says, Tadityanabhisandhaya Phalam Yajna Tapakriyaha Dana Kriyascha Vividaha Kriyante Moksha Kangshibhi. Tat, that, iti, thus, Phalam, the fruit, Anabhisandhaya, without expecting, without aiming, Moksha Kangshibhi, the seekers of Moksha or Mumukshu, Vividaha, various Yajna Tapakriyaha, acts of Vedic sacrifice and austerity, Dana Kriyaha, acts of charity, cha, and kriyante performed. So tad iti anabhisandaya, uttering that without aiming at fruits and the various acts of yajna, austerity and gift performed by the seekers of moksha. So without aiming at fruits, without seeing any benefits, without seeking any benefits, all these acts of charity, yajna and austerity, they are performed by mumukshus or people who are seeking moksha, uttering tat. So earlier Shri Krishna said that they will do uttering om. Now he is saying they will do uttering tat. So then he will say they will utter sat. So that's what om tat sat will be uttered. He says sadbhave sadubhave cha sad iti etat prayujyate prashaste karmani tatha sat shabda partha yujyate. Partha, O Partha, O son of Pritha, that is son of Kunti, Arjuna, sadbhave in the sense of reality, sadubhave in the sense of, bhava here means in the sense of goodness, cha and sat, sat, sat means the ultimate reality, iti, thus, etat, this prayujyate is used, tatha, so long, prashaste, auspicious, karmani in the sense of an act, cha and sat, sat, the word sat, shabdaha, the word yujyate is used. So the idea is the word sat is used in the sense of sadbhave, means in the sense of eternal reality, that which exists every time, eternal existence, and in the sense of goodness, sadubhave, in the sense of goodness, and so also means it is also used in the sense of mangalam, an auspicious act. Prashaste karmani means mangala karmani, mangala. Mangalam means auspicious. Prashasta means here auspicious. So it is used, this word sat. So a person who does all these austerity, yajna and gift, uttering om tat sat, that person is a person who is following Vedas, a person who is desiring moksha. Yajne tapasi dane cha sthiti saditi chochyate karma chaiva tadarthiyam saditye vabhidhiyate. So yajne in yajna, tapasi in austerity, dane in gift or charity, cha and sthiti hi steadiness, sat sat iti uchyate is called, so it is called, cha also tadarthiyam in connection with these or for the sake of the Lord or the ultimate principle Brahman, karma action cha eva as also sat, sat iti eva, so abhidhiyate is called. So steadiness in yajna, austerity and gift is also called sat. So sat means something which is steady also, and also something which you do, an action which you do in connection with these, that is austerity, yajna and gift, that is also called sat. So in connection with these, why? Because for the sake of the Lord, in connection with these, for the sake of the Lord, whatever you do, that is also called sat. So finally Sri Krishna says, what is asat? What is the opposite of sat? So sat we saw, it is for goodness, it is for auspiciousness, it is for reality. What is the opposite of sat? Ashraddaya hutam dattam tapas taptam kritam chayat asadat asad iti uchyate partha na cha tat pretya no iha asadityuchyate partha na cha tat pretya no iha. Ashraddhaya, without Shraddha, hutam, that which is ahutam, sacrificed, dattam, given, taptam, practiced, tapaha, austerity, cha and yat whatever kritam performed asat asat iti so uchyate is called partha o partha tat it nacha neither pretya hereafter after death no nor iha here so whatever is sacrificed given or performed and whatever austerity is practiced without shraddha it is called asat o partha it is neither here nor hereafter it is neither here nor hereafter so Swami Vivekananda says that whatever a person does one has to be doing that with shraddha he says the difference between a person who is successful and one who is unsuccessful is the difference in shraddha he says this word cannot be translated into English but this word is this shraddha is what we need today so why if a person does do something without shraddha it is asat and it is asat means asat also means unreal so it is neither here nor hereafter because though it causes lot of trouble it is of no use without shraddha if something is done which is a sacrifice or a charity or an austerity it is of no use either in this life or hereafter as it is not acceptable by the wise people in this life and it cannot produce any good effect for the hereafter because it is done without shraddha shraddha we know the definition of shraddha shastreshu guruvakyeshu vishwasah one who that is faith in scriptures and the words of the teachers so if one does not have shraddha everything is useless whatever one does and so that is why this shloka is an apt ending to this chapter which is called shraddha traya vibhaga yoga yogah the classification of shraddha into three kinds the yoga of the classification of shraddha into three kinds iti shraddha traya vibhaga yoga nama saptadasho adhyayah so here ends the 17th chapter called shraddha traya vibhaga yoga the chapter of classification of shraddha into three kinds om shanti 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 hari om tat sat shri ramakrishna arpanamastu